You know how many people don't know the real essence?
You know what right here?
We put too much.
Let me tell you a secret. Okay. At one time, when the Hell's Angels, when the Hell's Angels came to the Bronx, the first and only time the Hell's Angels came to the Bronx, because they came to, you know how they came to the Bronx? They came to the Bronx to stop the savage no-man from flying their colors. They said they can't fly the colors. I said, well, I told Charlie, I said, Charlie, you can put on whatever the fuck you want to put on. Nobody can't tell you nothing in the Bronx.
They came in the Bronx. I remember that. Then they tried to hook up with them all.
Let me tell you something. If you chew excess can stop it from the street, you should be able to stand in the rain. Why? Because it's the only time we took a fucking bath. Right. If you want to get out of it, it's the only time we took a bath. So how you going to be afraid of the rain? And it's the only time we took a bath.
That's
the
truth,
man.
I want to go outside.
When you tell the motherfucking truth. When you earn these boots, when you earn that boots, that's the only time you took a bath. And if your clothes didn't fall off you, you didn't take them off.
That's how you get it clean.
I have a question to you, you know. I'm out here this afternoon and we see black, Latino, everybody all together. In 2008, there seems to be a real emphasis, even in New York, to try and keep black and brown divided. What's that about? And talk about the type of unity that we've had for so long.
Well, you know, ever since Columbus landed here, ever since we were brainwashed and put labels on Dominican, Puerto Rican, etc. Ever since that, we've been dealing with this nonsense. So it's not a new phenomenon. It's a case of not knowing knowledge of self. Once you know knowledge of self, you know that we all have a common bond. Okay, there's only one race, and that's the human race. So in some way, shape, or form, we are all related.
Okay,
so on top of that, you know, it's not so much a matter of race or what have you. It's a matter of a class system that has been established.
Oh, that's real talk right there, the class.
And that's what separates us. It's more an economic sort of enslavement mentality, you know, because you have white people that are also dirt broke, are not really thrilled with what the government's doing. And so we have a common bond.
Right.
And just because they're Caucasian, that doesn't really mean nothing. They like to have their shindigs and what have you, and have fun and you know, stomp around in the barn the same way we like to do it in the plazas and the PJs, you know what I mean?
Right.
So really, I mean, it's a matter of knowing who you are. Like for us, you know, I thank Afrika Bambaataa because he was always into teaching knowledge itself. For a lot of us Zulus, you know, we started to realize that through his teachings and through other great teachers we've had, we learned that, for instance, Cuba is a Taino word. They kept the name Cuba. You know, Jamaica, that's a Taino word. There were Tainos running through those islands.
Taino Indians,
yes, indigenous people of these islands, of the so-called West Indian Islands in the Caribbean. So, you know, once you start breaking down these barriers and you start finding out that we are the same mixture, you know, even with our Arab brothers, you know, you see some cats in these grocery stores from Yemen and you feel like speaking Spanish to them because you think they're Puerto Rican or like Dominican.
Right.
And meanwhile, they look exactly like we do. Why? Because the Moors were in Spain for 800 years.
That's real.
You heard? Right. So, I mean, you could get deeper and deeper into the roots of history and you'll find that there is very little difference between us or among us, you know, and the dots could get connected until the beginning of time, you know.
Right.
So that's what's up for me. You know, I encourage people to learn about yourself, learn about your culture, learn true history, not only what you learn in school, but challenge what you learn in school.
Now, you know, if people want to find out how to get a hold of you and your documentary that you've been working on, how can they do that?
Okay, well, the best way to reach me is MySpace.com/PopMasterFable on the MySpace jump off.
Okay.
Until I do have PopMasterFable.com, and if you go there, there's a link to my It takes you right to my MySpace.
Okay. That's,
and Fable is spelled F-A-B-E-L, not L-E. I'm not okay. a fairy tale or a myth. I'm very
before
real.
We go, Fable, before we go, you know, some of the people that you got in your documentary, can you introduce us to one of your folks here and maybe get a question from us?
Okay, all right. Well, it's my honor and my pleasure to introduce Karate Charlie, the president of the Ghetto Brothers. This is one of my mentors, one of the brothers I looked up to.
Karate Charlie, you know, with hip-hop and you all being with the Ghetto Brothers, you know, first of all, are you surprised to see how far it's come?
Yes, I am. Well, not really, because when I left, I went AWOL from the Marine Corps. As soon as I saw the drugs and the violence, I said to myself, I got no business going back to fight in Vietnam when I have a war here in my own backyard.
Right.
So I took off the uniform of the government and put on the government the uniform of the people. I became a Ghetto Brother.
You know, one of the things I read when we read Jeff Chang's book about the Ghetto Brothers was that you all stood up to the police. Y'all didn't really run away from them. What has happened that we run from the police in New York City, whereas the Ghetto Brothers in the spades never did? Y'all protected the community from police brutality. What do you think has happened?
The youth needed a leader, someone that would say, I will be your father. We were raised with our fathers. Mm. So they needed someone that would say, I will be your overseer. I will protect you. I, Karate Charlie, was the protector in the Hispanic community. Bam Bam, Africa, in the black community, was watching over the black community. When we became a family, then we all started talking. How can we protect our communities?
Right.
And when the peace treaty came together, we sat down and talked. How can we become stronger? And the police had to take a step back.
Right.
Because we were watching over the trains. I taught martial arts. I'm a jiu-jitsu black belt, judo black belt, and karate black belt.
Right.
I taught my Ghetto Brothers how to walk up and down the subways, and if they saw any violence,
so way before we had the Guardian Angels, y'all were the original
Guardian Angels. That gave the Guardian Angels. When that character came and said, put on the shirts and the red beret, my brothers were already on the train.
Wow.
And my brothers were already giving lessons in Spanish.
Okay.
I taught lessons the way I can teach you right now. K-O-M-O-S. Como se M-A-M-A. Como se llama.
And my last question, did you all, the Ghetto Brothers and the Black Spades, did you all have a relationship?
They were the key. I needed support. I went to the Spades. Mm. I went to the Skulls.
Right.
The Skulls were powerful black. The Spades was powerful black.
Right.
They both were in love. I was a big mouth.
Well, there you go.
I knew how to be a diplomatic. Thank you.
Well, you know, we want to thank you, Karate Charlie. You know, we're going to tell everybody. Oh, sorry, that's right. Got to do the right hand. We've been talking with my man, Karate Charlie. And
Fable.
That's right. And Fable, man, so we're going to have to remind everybody. We want to see more of you and Karate Charlie. And a lot of these people that's out here for the 40th anniversary.
Yes,
what's
sir.
The name of that flick?
Apache 9 from Gangs to Hip Hop.
And I just and finished writing a book.
Yes, you just finished writing?
I smiled to keep from crying.
Yes.
Because the anger was so great. But I held the tears.
And so, you know, it's also good that you guys are actually telling your own story. It's not PBS. It's not ABC.
It's not.
It's
right.
You guys yourself. So this
right
is the source.
Yes,
right.
Sir.
And
yes,
I don't
sir.
Want anybody to come and say, I want an actor. I don't want an actor. I want my brother to stand and say, hey, this is where it hurts. These are my scars.
There you go. We're out for now, folks. We'll be back.
Peace, David D. Rock on.